how to start a gentleman wardrobe, or to put it differently, how to buy your first suit or first suits with success. The first answer to this question is, first of all, it's not a science. So everything that I'm going to share with you today, you have to put this into challenges with your own taste, your own means, your own wallet, your own profession, your own areas of interest. Because of course, if you're a banker or a consultant, or if you work in the tech industry, you will not dress the same. If you are 21 years old, or if you have 65 years old, you will not dress the same. The only thing I can share with you today is my own experience. I started, I would say 15 years ago. Back in these years, I had a pretty decent wardrobe, or I thought I had a pretty decent wardrobe. I had probably like 5 or 6 suits so that I can shuffle them. I can make sure I don't wear the same suit 2 days in a row. But when I started to really deep dive in this sartorial education and everything about tailoring and shoemaking and elegance, reading people like Bruce Boyer or Bernard Russell, Alan Fraser, I discovered that my wardrobe that I thought was kind of decent was absolutely not good. Because when you step into this world, you start to see things differently. And it's quite interesting that you immediately see things that you didn't see. It was right there in front of your eyes for many years, but you were unable to spot them. So the first thing you may have to do, it's a little bit painful at the beginning, but it's the way it works. If you really want to go on quality clothing and on dressing well the sartorial way, you may have to get rid entirely of your former wardrobe. In my case, I got rid of 6 suits out of 7. Only 1 suit remained in my wardrobe to start with. It was, if I remember well, a Francesco Smalto single-breasted blue suit that was beautiful. It was, by the way, at the time, probably the first tailored style suit I had in my wardrobe. But all the rest, I gave away. So when you are starting from zero, like I was starting literally from zero, the first thing you have to consider is how versatile my first suit that I will buy would be. Because if you only have the means to buy one at a time, maybe some people have the means to buy 2 or 3, but let's say you have the means to buy one at a time, you have to really go to the basics and make sure that the first suit you buy will cover many different occasions in life, business, personal life, weekend, formal events, dinners, etc., etc. So for that, I'm afraid you can't escape buying as a first suit a grey suit. But when I say grey suit, many people say, grey suits are boring, you look like a banker, or you look like a lawyer. Well, it's not exactly true. If you take a kind of an anthracite suit, this light grey, yes, you can easily look like the guy around the corner, like every man in a suit has a grey suit. But if you go a little bit darker in the grey, not too dark, because it can become, on the contrary, a little bit, you know, too serious, a little bit austere. But if you go kind of a mid-grey suit, you will discover that a mid-grey suit not only is an extremely versatile suit, but moreover, you will use this suit a long, long time. And if you are a follower of Sartorial Talks since a few episodes or since the beginning, the suit I was wearing in the last couple of episodes was a grey suit. And if I remember well, I was saying in one of these episodes that I had these suits for more than 10 years. And it was my first suit, and it was a grey suit. And I still use it today. Why? Because it's extremely versatile. So, grey is your best friend if you start a wardrobe. In terms of cut and style, I will not go too far as a first suit. I will, once again, of course, it depends on your taste and what you are looking for. If you want to immediately step out of the crowd and, you know, be a little bit dandified and really make a stylistic statement with your suit, of course you can go with large lapel, whatever. But if you want to start more discreetly and go on this learning curve, this sartorial learning curve, which is really, it's a learning curve. your taste can be refined more and more. I really advise you to go quite softly also on the suit. In my case, my first suit was a single-breasted, two buttons, notch lapels, with lapel size which were moderate. Please don't go on these skinny lapels that you see everywhere on the market. This is for young kids. And even young kids, if they are becoming sartorially inclined, you will very quickly discover that a larger lapel is much more interesting for a man. So don't go to this, please, this skinny lapel that you see everywhere. It's not, in my opinion, very elegant. Go to some mid-sized lapels and two buttons, single-breasted. That's the first suit every man should own, because a two-button, single-breasted, mid-gray suit will basically cover 90% of the situation. And moreover, you can pair it with a blue shirt, with a white shirt, with any kind of shirt, and practically any kind of ties, and more important, practically any kind of shoes. So it's extremely versatile. So when you buy your first gray suit, there's one thing which is extremely important. Avoid, by all means, to buy a fused suit. So what is a fused suit? If you are following Sartorial Talks, you may know a little bit more now. But let me re-clarify this concept very quickly. A suit is made of an outside part of an inside part. A suit has guts. You know, you have the lining, and in between the lining and the fabric, you have what we call a canvas, which is a piece of cloth, which aims is to make sure that the suit is structured, that is not falling apart, is structured. On a bad quality suit, this piece of canvas will be glued to the fabric directly. It means that when you wear it three or four times, you may start to see that it's losing its shape. A good quality suit will have a floating canvas. That is to say that the canvas inside is free, and it's quite easy to check. First of all, normally you have to ask a salesman, and if it's a good salesman or a good shop assistant, he will tell you. But you would be surprised sometimes that even them, they don't even know what fused or free-floating canvas means. So in this case, you just use your hands, and you take the fabric of the suit, and you take the lining inside, and you do this. And if you're able to feel there's a piece of cloth in the middle, which is that you can feel, this is a canvas suit. If you can't do this, I mean, if the things stay together, it's a fused suit. Avoid fused suit. Why? Because today, even on a budget around $300 or $400, for example, at Suit Supply or other brands like that, you can have access to half canvas or even full canvas suits. So that's good news, since I would say 5-6 years, more than ever, you have access to quality suiting, no matter your mean. Of course, if you can go make to measure, go make to measure. And if you can go bespoke, of course, go directly to bespoke. But you can really access good quality suits for very affordable prices. So number one, a gray suit, preferably single-breasted and preferably in mid-gray. This suit will last you all your life, and you're going to use it a lot. The second suit I will advise you to have, and that's what I did when I restarted my wardrobe, is a blue suit. And in my case, I chose a dark blue suit. It's interesting because some people will probably challenge me on the first suit, saying that maybe why don't you go first blue and then gray, instead of first gray and then blue. Well, in my case, I went gray first because it was good for my lifestyle. I had to wear a suit for my business, so it was much more interesting. But it's true also that a blue suit can be very versatile. Why? Because if you have the right buttons on it, it can also be used without the trousers as a blazer. So with one suit, you have two outfits possible. So it might be one or the other. In my case, I choose the gray first, but you can maybe go for the blue. But why blue is so important to have? First of all, it's a very versatile color also that you can basically pair with any kind of shirts and ties and shoes. Secondly, if you go like dark blue or even navy blue, you immediately have something which is a little bit more refined than a mid-gray that you can use. For example, my first blue suit, it was my second suit. Oh, I choose to go double-breasted, but that's another subject that I will not cover right now because that's a matter of choice. But I use this suit preferably at night because dark blue is very interesting to use in a more formal occasion. When you wear well a well-cut navy blue suit, immediately you are in a more formal situation or a more formal image of yourself. So gray and blue, or blue and gray, preferably solid colors, because you will have plenty of time to try your checks and to try your stripes on your patterns or your window panes or whatever, or your Prince of Wales. But I will strongly advise that you start with two suits, one gray, mid-gray, one dark blue, plain colors, single-breasted, two buttons, simple, versatile. And on the blue suit, you check on the buttons so that you can use it as a blazer. And with these two suits, you cover more or less 100% of the situation in life.